The wall is 3.2 meters high and consists of 51 millimeters multiply 102 millimeters studs plastered on one side. On the other side is 13 millimeters fiberboard and 102 millimeters clay brick. Determine the average load in kilonewton per meters of length of wall that the wall exerts on the floor. Repeat again. We need to determine the average load in kilonewton per meters of length of wall that the wall exerts on the floor. First of all, we need to look at the picture at the left. We see the height of wall is 3.2 meters. So, we can determine the problems easily. Look at the table 1.3 about minimum design dead loads. We see the wall clay brick, which thickness is 102 millimeters, is 1.87 kilonewton per square meters. After that, we see the frame partitions and wall, which related to our problem, wood studs plastered on one side is 0.57 kilonewton per square meters. The 13 millimeters fiberboard is 0.04 kilonewton per square meters. Hence, we multiply the minimum design dead loads of wall clay brick with height of our wall. The answer of the weight of wall clay brick is 36.225 kilonewton per meter. The answer of the weight of studs is 1.824 kilonewton per meter. And also the answer of the fiberboard is 0.128 kilonewton per meter. After we know the dead loads of each materials, we can find the average loads of length wall that the wall exerts on the floor. Therefore, the answer is 7.936 kilonewton per meter. Here is a way that we computed average loads of length wall that exerts on the floor. Do you think this video helped you or not? If it is helpful, like, comment and share this video to your classmates. Thanks.